Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock. Thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the film Freeheld, based on real-life events, a story about a brave New Jersey cop who was diagnosed with terminal lung cancer. She just wants equality. I sat down with the two actresses who star in the film, Ellen Page, Julianne Moore, and their co-star, Michael Shannon, who plays really the only ally this gal has in the film.
My name is Detective Laurel Hester. I've worked for the Ocean County Police Department for 23 years. Recently, I was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer. When my heterosexual colleagues die, their pensions go to their spouses. But because my partner is a woman, I don't get to do that. In my career, I've never asked for special treatment. I'm only asking for equality.
Clearly, there's a connection here.
Mm-hmm.
Did it start on the set? When did you guys meet?
What? We met like 2 weeks before production, basically,
But luckily, we connected. Yeah, totally.
We drove all the way out here to play volleyball and you don't even like it?
Every now and then I think she'd go out and
try and meet someone.
Yeah.
There's that great scene in the movie where you've got that icebreaker of a scene where you two meet in the film after the volleyball game. How do you guys connect? What's the icebreaker when two actresses connect on a project like this?
I feel like I overshare.
No,
you know what I mean. I'm just like, let's just get this over with. You know.
Yeah, I know, but you know what? Ellen came to my house. It was so, and I don't know. Did I invite you? Did I just say come to my house? I think I did. You know what?
I just showed up.
No,
I just knocked like, on your door.
Knock.
I was like,
well, you know, it was weird because we wanted to meet, and sometimes when you meet like in a public place, people are like, whoa, why are they meeting? And somebody takes a picture and whatever. So I was like, just come over. But then, of course, there's that moment when somebody knocks on your door and you're like, hi, person I don't know, come in.
If you could have anything, what would it be? What's your dream?
A house, a dog, a woman I love, loves me.
Me too.
It is an amazing story how long this project has been in here for you.
Mm-hmm.
And watching this whole thing unfold. So when she wins the Oscar, are you thinking, oh, this is perfect timing for this film that's meant so much to you?
No, I'm not actually thinking about the film because Julie and I did become close because I consider Julie a friend.
Yeah,
I was just so thrilled for her, and I was actually in Brazil at the time, and I couldn't watch it, so I'm like on my phone, it's the middle of the night, and I was just, the only thing I was so elated for this person that I love and respect and admire so much, and so I was just so excited for her, yeah.
We were excited for you, too, and I've really never met you, except
today. Everybody loves Julie.
What did Stacey think? I mean, I would imagine for her that this has been cathartic, emotional, a combination of all of it.
Yeah, it's been, I think
it's been a lot.
It's been a lot. It was, we both spent, time with Stacey. Ron Nicewander, of course, who wrote the screenplay, and she was so kind and so generous and so vulnerable, because you can imagine it's an emotional experience talking about Laurel, memories of this, etc. So much. She just shared so much, and thankfully, it's hard to say enjoyed the film, really.
Yeah.
You know,
but she did feel it was authentic.
Absolutely.
That was so important to us that she felt like they were the experience was what was represented authentically. That's really the heart of the story.
Mm-hmm.
These wonderful women and their relationship and what they did and we want to honor that,
If they say yes, then my tax dollars go to her girlfriend.
Yeah, the same way your wife gets your pension if you die.
Yeah, but she's my wife.
Hell, if you and I got married tomorrow, I'd be entitled to your benefits.
Is that a proposal?
Oh, my God. Well, I just was very inspired by what Laurel did. You know, I think it's easy to feel like you're powerless and that you can't get what you deserve sometimes in our culture and a society, and Laurel refused to take no for an answer, and I thought that was very inspiring.
I heard that the real Dane Wills was just a big fan of yours.
Did
you know that when you first met him? Was he giddy or was he very
Dane doesn't get giddy, really. He's a pretty quiet fella, very thoughtful and respectful, but when I met him, I said I don't really feel like I'm much like you, I don't resemble you really. And he said, oh, that's all right. You don't have to impersonate me. He said he was a fan of Boardwalk Empire and he was just happy that I was doing it.
It's heartbreaking to watch and it's exhausting at times to watch, especially as you get sicker and sicker. Are those days exhausting days? the days as her illness progressed and just the emotion of it, are those days more exhausting?
I wouldn't say they're exhausting. I mean, I think you're concentrating so hard on just making everything work. And we were also felt so privileged to be there that we loved doing the work. But my favorite day was the day where we did the dance scene, you know, mm-hmm. so a day like that, which mm-hmm. is so about the beginning of a relationship. And that was just so much fun.
Because it's a lot of people that go into making a film. And I really do feel like there was just such a beautiful
support,
team
yeah.
and like emotional team effort. It really yeah. felt like everyone was invested in telling the story.
The only thing I care about is justice for the woman that I love.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film Freeheld. Hey, by the way, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And do you have your loyalty cup yet? I hope so.